Welcome everyone. Today we will be discussing about how to conquer CSAT paper 2. So this video is presented by me, Arjun Mohan, from team Enlite. So first of all, we need to discuss what is CSAT paper 2 is all about. See, you all know the rules of the game. So the first thing is, the paper consists of 80 questions, with each question having 2.5 marks and the total marks being 200 marks. So the very important next rule, which everyone should care, that is how much marks we need to qualify for the paper. As you all know, this is just a qualifying paper, but don't underestimate this paper. We have to get the required qualifying mark, if better, more than that. So everyone should score at least 33% of the total marks, which comes to around 66-67 marks. So that is your benchmark, but I strongly advise that you have to score more than 80. That will be a safe zone, so that you need not worry at all. You will be in the safe zone. So there are 80 questions, each question having 2.5 marks, total 200 marks, and you have to get a minimum of 33% marks to qualify the exam. And each question carrying 2.5 marks, and each question also has a negative mark. If you got the answer wrong, it will be having 1 by 3rd of the total marks, that is 2.5 divided by 3, which will be deducting around 0.833 marks. So that you should be very careful, your accuracy should be high, that will help you easily score the required marks. So another important factor you have to notice, the exam time is 2 hours. You have to attempt the number of questions within 2 hours. So time is very, very important. 2 hours you have to attempt a maximum of around 40 to 50 questions, so that you are safe. So let us look about the question pattern. You all know that there are mainly 3 subjects we have to cover in CSAT paper 2, one being English, the other being reasoning, the other is quantitative aptitude. So what perfect mix of strategy you have to adopt to get the minimum qualifying marks? So here we have a slide of the question pattern from 2015-2018. Just look at that. You can see that last year the maximum weightage is for reasoning, amounting for 36 questions, and quantitative aptitude getting 18 questions and English 26 questions. So just assume that you are attempting reasoning alone. So 36 questions, which will, if you are attempting 36 and all 36 are correct only, you will be getting around 72 plus 18, that is 90 marks you will be getting if you are attempting reasoning and you have 100% accuracy. But just if you are attempting quantitative aptitude alone, you will be just getting around 45 marks, which is far less than the required qualifying marks. So the earlier year also, you can see that if you attempt only one portion, be it reasoning or quantitative aptitude or English, you will not be getting the required qualifying marks. So you have to adopt a perfect mix of questions. You have to attempt a certain number of English questions, a certain number of reasoning, and a certain number of quantitative aptitude, which will be the perfect strategy in this exam. So what will be your strategy? You are going to attempt English maximum or max maximum or reasoning. What will be your strategy? So as far as I am concerned, I am good in reasoning and quantitative aptitude. So my maximum choice will be attempting max and reasoning. Even though it takes time, the thing is that if you get the answer, you have the answer in the option, almost it is verified. In case of English, it is not like that. You'll be having confusion and answer may be different in the UPSC answer key. So as far as I am concerned, I will be advising you to attempt maximum reasoning and max if you are strong in that area. Otherwise, if you are strong in English, you are very good in your language, you should attempt English maximum. So it is up to you. You as an individual, you have to make the perfect choice. And that one advantage I can tell you for reasoning and quantitative aptitude is that you do the answer, you get an answer, it is in the answer key, it is almost verified. It is in the answer choices, it is almost verified, and it is just like 100% accurate. So I advise that the perfect strategy is yours. You have to devise your strategy. You are good in mathematics, do maximum quantitative aptitude. You are good in reasoning, do maximum reasoning. You are good in English, attempt English. So, but don't choose a single subject alone. You have to choose a certain number of questions from English, a certain number from reasoning, and a certain number from quantitative aptitude. So, now we have to discuss what strategy we have to adopt. So, the first strategy that I already told you should attempt a perfect mix of questions, a certain number of questions from English, a certain number of questions from quantitative aptitude, and certain number of questions from reasoning. And the second very important thing, you have to focus on time and speed. Remember that you are getting only 2 hours. You have to attempt maximum number of questions within that 2 hours. Within that time also, you have to fill the answer paper also. That means you have to be very careful in utilizing the time and speed. If you are doing quantitative aptitude or reasoning, you have to be very careful. Don't get stuck in one question. One question is not going to define your future. So, the thing is that do maximum simple questions, do maximum number of attempts, increase your accuracy, focus on the time and speed. So, how to study CSAT? So, don't underestimate the CSAT paper. You have to get the qualifying paper. There are a certain section of people who is not getting qualified only because they are not getting the qualifying marks in CSAT. So, just remember that it is very easy to crack CSAT if you have given a certain amount of preparation. So, the best strategy will be to sort the previous 4 year question papers. That is enough if you are good at mathematics or reasoning or English. Just solve the previous question paper, just solve 4 years question paper, that is enough for your preparation. But if you think that it is not enough, you can go for some basic books and just do some extra questions as well, which I will be mentioning in the next slide. So, how much time you need to prepare, invest in preparation? So, this is already March, there is just 2 months remaining for your examination. You have to study a lot number of subjects, so you have to study CSAT as well. So, what I advise is just invest 1 hour per week, or just you can do solve one question paper, one previous year CSAT question paper 1 week. Just check on your accuracy, just check on your speed. If it is okay, don't do much. Weekly you solve one CSAT paper, which is more than enough. But if you think you are lagging behind, what you need to do is just invest just half an hour or 1 hour daily for solving previous year question paper during the month of April. Don't stretch it to May because you have to study the current affairs. You have to focus on other GS papers. So, just do this. If you are lagging behind in quantitative aptitude or reasoning, just invest half an hour or daily 1 hour in the month of April solving previous year question papers and other basic question paper from the basic reference book. That will help you to easily get through the subject, easily score the required minimum qualifying marks. So, now we have to go through the syllabus. Here in the slide you can see the syllabus. Mainly we have comprehension, logical reasoning, basic numeracy and data interpretation. Other than this, we can also see general mental ability, decision making and problem solving. We can look at a basic question from basic numeracy. In the syllabus itself, UPSC has clearly mentioned that it is class 10 level. So, we will look at one question. So, here is the question. So, you can see that a shopkeeper is selling an article at 40 and is getting X percentage of profit. When he is selling the same item at 20, he is facing the same percentage of loss. So, the question is, what is the original cost of the article? And you have 4 options. See, on seeing the question, you will be very terrified. Sometimes you will see how to do the question. Just look at the options. Just read the question once more. A person has an article X in his hand. He sold it at 40. He will be earning a percentage, X percentage as profit. If he sold it at 20 rupees, he is making a loss of X percentage, the same percentage of loss. That means the original cost is anywhere between rupees 20 and rupees 40. It cannot be 40, it cannot be 20, it is anywhere between rupees 20 and 40. Just look at the options. Option A, rupees 10, it is eliminated. Option B, rupees 20, it is also eliminated. Option D, rupees 40, it is also eliminated. So, only option remaining is rupees 30, which is the correct answer. So, without doing it mathematically, with simple logic, with a simple reasoning, you are able to arrive at the answer. So, like this simple questions will be there. Otherwise, you can approach within mathematics method also. You can use the formula to find the percentage of profit and percentage of loss. You can equate it and find out the answer. But it requires time. Here it is a simple logic. Based on the options, you can solve the answer. So, you may be wondering what all reference book you have to go through. I repeat that if you are good in your syllabus, if you are good in CSET, you just need to do the previous year question paper, no extra preparation is required. So, here is a list of books which you can go through if you think required. The first one is Cracking CSET Paper 2 by Arihant. Arihant Publications, which is a book by Arihant Publications, which will also be containing the previous year question paper as well as other questions. And the second one is a CSET manual by Tata McGraw-Hill. And if you are looking for reasoning alone, we have a book by M.K. Pandey. And if you want to increase your proficiency in English, you have this Modern Approach to Verbal and Nonverbal Reasoning by R.S. Agarwal. And your master is the previous question paper itself. I repeat, previous year question papers. So, that is all from me. Just do the previous 4 year question paper. It is easy to qualify. Just don't overestimate that. Just don't underestimate the paper. Just do the required amount of preparation. You can easily sail over this CSAT paper too. Thank you.